Uplights. Why am I talking about this? Because I finally have what I consider a pretty decent amount of uplights. Took me several months to get the amount of uplights that I have now, because I just had to buy them a few at a time, because those things can get very expensive real fast. But I got 16 now. Big start in the uplighting part of the gigs. But I got my lights from New York. They're from a place called Lumin Llights. And pretty decent lights. They got 10 millimeter LEDs, and it's 144 of them in each light. And here they are right here. One all the way to 16. And every DMX cable I custom made myself. And all my power cables I got from monoprice.com. Pretty good price on, you know, long power cords and things like that, extenders and all that. And right now I just have controlling my uplights. The DMX signal will get to the uplights by, I have what is known as the Sirius E wireless DMX transceiver. And that's right here. And over here I just have another Sirius E transceiver. This is the transmitter. And over there is the receiver. And just using my basic Obey 3 right here, which I always use for my uplights. I also have a few more of these transceivers also. Got another set right here, but both of these are set up just for receivers. So if you want to, you know, if you got to space out your lights and things like that, you can have. What I have is I have three receivers and one transmitter, but you can set them up either way just by setting your jumper. I'm just going to turn off the lights here and just show you what they look like in my living room. I know they're pretty close together, so you're not going to get too much of a good wide angle kind of detail because they're just all on one wall right here. I'm going to shut off a few of these lights and show you what they look like in the dark. Okay, I'm starting off with the color white. Now, since this is a CMOS camera, CMOS lenses will image or sometimes will not show the true color just through a camera. All right, here's red. See, the entire room is red. And from about maybe 6 or 7 gigs that I've had with these uplights, I've only, you know, just finally got 16, but before then I had like 12 and then 8, 6, things like that. But so far, they shine pretty great in the building. Here's orange. Here is yellow. So these colors don't look exactly the same with this camera right here. Here's green. Let me just walk up so you can see exactly what they look like close up. Cyan. That's always a pretty cool color when you get these things set up in a room. Just how that color looks on the walls and everything. Transforms a room. Here's blue. Here's purple. Between purple and magenta and cyan, those are some nice colors if you're doing a wedding or party or something like that. Here's magenta. And every light I have set to DMX channel 1. And of course the last color on the presets here is white, which I started off with. Let me just hit white again. And plus you have your sliders here, you can adjust everything. Your fade times, your speed, your strobe, your master dimmer. You can dim them down if it's too bright for you. And you can do custom colors, macros, and things like that just with Obey 3. If you want to get into custom things with your lights as far as setting up a sequence or a scene or something, you can do something more advanced like the Obey 40 or your DMX USB controllers. That you can do with a PC, but they all do about the same thing, control your lights. It's basically whatever you want to use. So, just showing you, I finally have 16 uplights. And who knows, I might add more in the future. I might get up to 20, because you never know. Some rooms you might need a lot of lights to go around all rooms just to give it a nice atmosphere. But, practice and enjoy.